Did you know that Kubuntu is way more faster than Ubuntu? It's vastly more customizable than Ubuntu, and it just feels so familiar to use. It's simple. Despite these and many more great reasons, Kubuntu is criminally underrated. The main reason for that is actually the GNOME desktop environment. Yes, GNOME. GNOME is the most popular Linux desktop, so it's pre-installed on most distros. Or is it the most popular Linux desktop because most distros pre-install it? Whatever the reason may be, it's hard for people using GNOME to switch to Plasma, even if it's more powerful, more feature-rich, and just phenomenal. And that's including me. I have my issues with GNOME, but I'm a creature of habit, so I've been putting up with it. But I took Kubuntu 24.04 LTS for a spin over the weekend, and man, was I missing out. I'm a simple man, but the way I use a computer is not that simple. I have multiple apps running all the time, divided into multiple workspaces. There's a lot of data moving around from one app to another. I'm working with files, writing stuff, and there's a lot of chaos. Having a bottom panel based workflow does make it easier to stay organized and focused. And I like to have a simple menu with a quick search and apps organized into categories. I'm really not a fan of GNOME's app grid and search. While I appreciate how powerful it is, I don't like using it. Press the Windows or the Super button and all your working windows go flying around. But a simple menu popping up on the bottom left is just not intrusive. That's one thing that I loved about Windows 7. Plasma also has a simple launcher that lets you get to apps and files quickly. You invoke this by pressing Alt plus Space, and a small text box pops up on the top of your desktop. This gives you real-time results as you start pressing keys on your keyboard. It's very nimble. Man, does KD Plasma make it easier to stay focused, organized, and productive? You have workspaces to organize multiple windows, the bottom panel lets you quickly switch between apps, and there's a phenomenal tiling mechanism that many people don't know about. You press the super button plus T to bring up the tiling layout. Here, you can drag the borders, add and remove these tiles, and configure the whole thing any way you want. Then, you can drag and drop windows while holding down Shift to drop them into these tiles. And this whole thing works so flawlessly, and you are getting the best of both worlds here. You can tile the apps that you want, and the apps you want to use without tiling, you can use them without tiling. And this tiling feature is so intuitive, you can feel the polish here. Kubuntu looks very good visually, great actually. This is not the latest version of Plasma, which is Plasma 6. This is actually Plasma 5.27. Kubuntu is a stability-oriented distro, and Plasma 6 was too new at the time of the release of Kubuntu 24.04 LTS. So it comes with a slightly older but a well-tested version of Plasma. Of course, Plasma 6 will be backported to Kubuntu sometime later. But right now, things look good. The desktop itself is visually appealing. The animations and effects are top-notch. They're not overly done, but still, you can feel the polish when interacting with this system. But Kubuntu is not just about the looks. Kubuntu 24.04 LTS kills it in the performance department thanks to KD Plasma. While there is no shortage of lightweight, performance-driven desktop for Linux, they do sacrifice that modern aesthetic. They lack animations, effects, latest rendering techniques, and you can feel their age. But not Plasma. Plasma is a modern desktop that's on the forefront of tech. It looks great, has stunning visuals, and provides a performance-optimized desktop. Plasma utilizes significantly less system resources when compared to GNOME, and it's very snappy. On the same hardware, you will feel a difference in the responsiveness between the main Ubuntu and Kubuntu. Of course, this difference is vastly negligible on newer and powerful hardware. On newer hardware, both GNOME and Plasma perform on par with each other. But on even slightly older and moderately powered hardware, Plasma starts showing its edge. Plasma's optimized resource usage means more resources are available for user applications, helping them run smoother. This also makes Kubuntu the better option for slightly older hardware. I'm not talking ancient hardware here, just slightly aging hardware, and you want to get a little bit more out of it, all while enjoying a contemporary computing experience. Kubuntu is going to be surprisingly good here. The kernel underneath here has been tuned for a balanced delivery of performance and stability. It brings improved support for many new devices and performance tune-ups across job scheduling, disk management, and memory handling as well. Alright, it's pro tip time. You can quickly press Shift plus Alt plus F12 to disable the compositor, which turns off all the desktop effects. This gives you an immediate CPU boost and makes the system slightly more responsive. This is a great trick to use on older machines. on newer hardware, the difference is not that pronounced. You can press Shift plus Alt plus F12 to enable the compositor again. Remember, it's Shift, not Control. If you press Ctrl plus Alt plus F12 and go to this black screen, press Ctrl plus Alt plus F2 or some other function key to get back to your desktop. By the way, if you haven't already, check out my course Linux Mastery Express. I've designed this course to level up your Linux skills very quickly. With this course, you'll get so comfortable using the terminal commands that your friends will think you're a Linux wizard. You'll get perfect with the most used, most useful commands and also learn advanced things like using the v-editor and shell scripting as well. Linux Mastery Express, link in the description, do check it out. I'm a hardcore Linux enthusiast and I absolutely love playing with the newest tech of bleeding edge distros. However, my work demands that I use something stable. Things like Arch Linux, Manjaro and even Fedora can be a bit too exciting for my work. After trying hundreds of distros, I've come to realize that I need something Ubuntu-ish. Linux Mint has become my go-to companion and the fact that it's Ubuntu-based is a big deciding factor. Kubuntu is Ubuntu. Under that shiny KDE plasma, it's exactly the same system as Ubuntu. And with that base, you get all the benefits that Ubuntu is known for. The rock-solid stability of Ubuntu is a big one for most people. With a support period of 5 years, Kubuntu is going to be a hassle-free system for everybody. Install Kubuntu, set it up with all the drivers, all the applications that you use, and you can forget about the housekeeping or doing maintenance work for your operating system for the next half a decade. That peace of mind is a big thing. Have a single working time shift backup and apply updates conservatively, and you're good to go. This system will be supported for a really long time, so once you install it, you can focus on your studies, projects, or whatever it is that you do, without having to think about the system ever again. The software packages that Kubuntu gives you are all very well tested and slow moving as far as updates are concerned. So almost any package that you install here will be confirmed working 100% fine. And things don't change too often. So you're not caught in that cycle of learning how to use the new options and just as you're getting comfortable, a new update rolls and things change again. That's not an issue here. Things are very stable and dependable. Where Kubuntu really shines is the expanse of its software repositories. As the most popular Linux distro family, it enjoys phenomenal software availability. Pretty much every software vendor that creates software for Linux will have a well-tested and official version for Ubuntu fully compatible with this system. Then, there's everything in the software repositories. Programming languages, utilities, office tools, games, and everything else. With Kubuntu, you will never have to worry about how to install a particular piece of software. If it's available for Linux, it will be available for direct and convenient installation in one way or another. Kubuntu 24.04 LTS does not ship with the new Ubuntu's Flutter App Center. While I liked App Center's design, it is filled with snaps and doesn't really make it convenient to install and work with .deb packages. But here, we get the good old Discover, which comes from KDE Plasma itself. And this brings about some important ramifications. Discover is the game changer here. Firstly, the Discover software store that we get here is way better than Ubuntu's App Center. But the App Center is very new at the moment and this is its first major release. And for an initial release, it's surprisingly good. But Discover is more mature and feature-rich. The App Center from Ubuntu doesn't expose full native .deb software packages in a good way yet. And I don't like that fact. They're not shown in any of the software exposed here and you can install them only if you manually search for them with the deb package filter. Again, I don't like this. It leans on snaps almost exclusively. Let's talk about snaps. While I prefer .deb versions for software installation, I sometimes have to use snaps when .debs aren't available. Honestly, I'm thankful for snaps. Snaps significantly enhance software availability, offering access to a vast repository from big and small developers like Google, Microsoft, Nextcloud, and Spotify. They make life easier by always providing the latest versions of packages, ensuring you don't miss out on any new features, improvements, and better security. You might have a complicated relationship with snaps like I do, but yeah, it's available. But I like having .deb packages as my primary software source, and you get that here on Kubuntu. .debs are first-class citizens here. I absolutely loved this about Kubuntu. Then we get Flatpaks here. Yep, you heard it right. We get full Flatpak access on Kubuntu. You can directly enable Flatpaks from the software sources here and plug in Flatup to that as well. And you can also choose the default between snaps and Flatpaks. And in the software page, you can select between snaps, flatpaks, and dot depths when installing the software. This dropdown. This is the dropdown that ultimately united all the people from the Kingdom of Snaps, the Republic of Flatpaks, and the Commonwealth State of Dev Packages. This is the dropdown that brought peace to our lands. All hail the mighty dropdown. Kubuntu's Discover is a giga software store. This just gives you everything you could ask for and gives it in a way we can handle. It doesn't overwhelm you. It provides simple yet deep control over package management. Love this. All in all, the software availability on Kubuntu is just top notch. Anything you want, just open up the software store here and you'll get it. Couldn't get simpler. Kubuntu is a very usable system out of the box. It has a very familiar starting point thanks to its similarities to Windows 7. Even Linux newcomers quickly grasp how to use this system. So the initial friction of not knowing where am I or what is this, it's not too big here. Kubuntu comes with sane defaults and a good set of pre-installed applications. KDE has a great ecosystem of apps, including the Dolphin File Manager, Ocular for document reading, Spectacle for powerful screenshots, and KDE Connect, which lets you pair your smartphone with your computer for cool things like remote control, wireless file sharing, and many other expected capabilities from your computer in 2024. KDE has around 200 high-quality apps in its ecosystem, covering a wide range of computational tasks. All these applications are highly configurable and powerful. But for someone new to KDE Plasma, these apps and the desktop itself are simple enough at the beginning. KDE Plasma is a very simple UI for day-to-day tasks and getting work done. However, if you want to customize it and make the system more your own, that's a huge rabbit hole. KDE Plasma allows you to do a mind-bending level of customizations on it, which can be overwhelming. I'd recommend starting to use it and slowly exploring things. The settings and the options themselves are very intuitive and simple to follow. The thing is, there are so many options here. But remember, getting into KDE Plasma customization can be addictive. And after a week long of work, after playing with customizations here, if you need some gaming time, then Kubuntu is a great system for that as well. The software manager has a ton of free games that you can directly install. Titles like Zero AD, Nexus, Alien Arena, Super Tux Kart can be hours of fun. Super Tux Kart is especially great to play with a friend if you use gamepads. But if you want to go a bit more AAA, then Steam is what you should be using. Steam has a huge library of games, and using its Steam Play feature, you can play thousands of major Windows exclusive titles on Linux with ease. Just enable Steam Play for all titles and you can play games like GTA 5, The Witcher 3 Wild Hunt, Cyberpunk 2077, Subnautica, and many more. You can use ProtonDB to check which Windows games work fine on Linux with Proton, which is the underlying tech for Steam Play. And if you have your own games, you can use this app called Bottles and use it to install Windows games on Linux with Proton. It's very simple to use and it's my go-to way of installing and working with Windows games and apps on Linux. Check it out. You can install Steam from the software store here. Alternatively, you can directly download Steam from their official website, which is how I do it. Overall, gaming on the new Kubuntu, really simple and enjoyable. Installation and getting started with Kubuntu is a simple affair. Download the ISO file, flash it onto a USB stick, live boot into it and start the installer. Of course, you can try Kubuntu from the live session itself and get a feel for how it'll run on your PC. The installer is very simple. We don't get the new Flutter installer that we saw in the newer Ubuntus here. But all the options here are represented in a very beginner-friendly way. I like that the partitioning is made very simple. You can just select the partition to replace Kubuntu with and it'll handle the rest automatically. Here too, you get the option to have a minimal installation as well as extended installation. The default should be fine for everybody. But the option to automatically install NVIDIA drivers that we get in the main Ubuntu is not available here. I didn't like that. But I could install the drivers by running a single command, which are given in the description below. Overall, getting started with Kubuntu was a breeze. The whole process took around 15 minutes and a cup of coffee. Kubuntu has very good community support. On the Kubuntu forums, there is a how-to guide subsection which is great for any questions relating to Kubuntu. The other thing is, since Kubuntu is Ubuntu under the hood, many how-to guides, troubleshooting articles written for Ubuntu will be applicable to Kubuntu as well. Of course, not things pertaining to the desktop. For desktop related help material, you can use guides written for KDE Plasma and that, there's a huge amount of. Since Kubuntu is an amalgamation of Ubuntu and KDE Plasma, you just need to know what to Google for when you get stuck somewhere or need any help. There's the Ubuntu part and there's the KDE Plasma part. Kubuntu also has an active IRC and a Telegram channel dedicated for community support. You can use those as well. All in all, there's a huge wealth of online help available for Kubuntu, and if you ever need any help regarding anything Kubuntu, it's just a Google search away. Kubuntu is a great system for people who love Ubuntu but not the way Ubuntu looks. When you want something with a familiar or traditional UI, all while being modern, dependable, and fully usable, Kubuntu is a great option. Linux Mint caters to the exact same audience, and see how popular that is. Kubuntu is just another option for those people. Kubuntu gets overlooked so often. Learning to use KDE Plasma is an investment that really pays off. It's not for everybody, but it is a cool desktop. And Kubuntu combines this desktop with the world's most popular distro to create a simple yet exceptionally powerful computing platform that can be used for work, play, and everything in between. You can download Kubuntu 24.04 LTS using the link given in the description below. Alright, if you enjoyed this video, if you found it helpful, definitely consider subscribing to the channel and also turn on the notifications so that you're the first one to know when anything major happens in the world of Linux. Don't forget to leave a big thumbs up too. And if you're interested in learning up your Linux skills, the link to my course Linux Mastery Express is given in the description below. It's designed to teach you Linux and take you from zero to hero within the shortest amount of time possible. You'll be using Linux like a pro within a matter of hours, so definitely check that out. By the way, Linux Mint 22 has rolled out and it's got some crazy new things going on. It's the next major release of the fan favorite Linux distro. I made a video on that, definitely don't miss that. Alright, this is Linux Techs, signing out.